any new major revenue source should be totally dedicated back to local communities to pick up the cost of education and cut the property tax.
He was a statesman by the definition of the word. For Walter Peterson, New Hampshire was his love, and he served it like a gentleman. The former two-term governor passed away Wednesday night after battling lung cancer. He was 88.
He was a reasonable, decent person who cared a lot about the state, had a very small ego, was willing to be on boards and serve.
Born in Nashua, Peterson graduated from Dartmouth College in 1947, married his wife Dorothy 2 years later, had 2 children, and a career in real estate. Considered a moderate Republican, Peterson became governor in 1969 and served for 4 years.
His legacy is the business profits tax. Because of Walter Peterson, this state has been able to maintain a no-income, no-sales tax mantra, and he did this by taking one of the greatest leaps of faith in the history of the state.
It was, ironically, his failure to pledge to veto a sales or income tax that contributed to his defeat in the primary as he sought a third term.
Walter Peterson was always able to put partisan politics to one side and work with everybody just to solve problems and work to make New Hampshire a better state. He set the tone.
Walter, had his own set of principles, and he was true to them. But he liked people, and people liked him.
After politics, Peterson served as the president of Franklin Pierce College, but remained civically active. Walter Peterson is remembered as a leader who pulled people together to strive for a common good. In Concord, Andy Hershberger, WMUR News 9.